So, we finished Love Island last Thursday, and now we're gonna move on to the bonus content. The reunion episode. This is the reunion episode, which is also the wedding, which is kind of trifling, because like, if I'm getting married, why is my best friend not here? Why is Gary's nan not here, you know? But that's life. C'est la vie. So let's get started. Welcome back to Love Island the Game Season 2. We are doing the reunion episode called The Wedding because someone's getting married. And who's getting married? It's me. I'm getting married. So let's just get into it. Ooh, do I not need tickets? It told me I needed tickets last time. It did tell me I needed tickets last time. Okay, we'll see. We'll see. Part 1. The Islanders are back together again and you've got a plan. Okay, I do need tickets. I don't know where that thing came from. Love is confusing. Love can be messy, but ultimately, love can change the world. Out of the 7 billion people on this planet, and 14 lucky islanders, you found your love. All that's left is to make it official. Welcome to Love Island, The Wedding. I can't wait! Oh, they got me in my cute little thing. Quick question, did you finish day 30 of season 2? It's fine if you didn't, I did. I finished season 2. You want to carry on your story from the end of season 2 or customize some things? Continue my season 2 story. After the finale, you and Gary left the villa hand in hand. Yes. The two of you soon found a place of your own and got busy decorating. His painting skills left a lot to be desired. Why didn't we just hire Chelsea? I'm sure she knows some handy people. Like, not that Gary's not handy, but Chelsea's literally an interior decorator, so she'll know people. She'll know painters. You didn't spend the prize money all at once, but that didn't stop you having some fun with it. Ooh, what did we do? Yeah, we totally lived it up, apparently. What did we do? And then, out of the blue, the invite for the reunion arrived. And the timing was perfect because then you made an important decision. There was a question you'd been meaning to ask Gary. I like how Shannon wasn't mentioned. I was doing my best to be Shannon's bestie. And you get to go on a trip with Shannon. Like, not, like, you know, visibly get to see it, but it's mentioned that you and Shannon are like besties and hanging out. And I wanted that. I wanted that dialogue option for us because I love Shannon. A pretty big question. And what better time to propose than surrounded by the friends you've made together during your time in the villa? There is other times to do this. The main thing to figure out was what to wear. Finally, they gave me new options. Ooh, I don't remember wearing this one, or maybe I do. But yes, finally they've given me options. I'm wearing this because this is sexy. This is the outfit. I can't wait to propose to Gary in it. I look good in white. And now it's time. The day's arrived, and in your pocket is a ring. What pocket? Where I got that ring? In my coochie? What the? Like, I have no pockets. I put it in my titty chest area. You and Gary walk into the room, and the bright lights dazzle you. It smells like pineapple and mango. Why is Gary wearing this outfit? That's not party outfit. But also, when I said titty chest area, I meant like people who wear bras, if you know, like you can put stuff in there. I do it all the time. I mean, is it a little gross? A little, but like, you don't got pockets. They don't make pockets for women apparently. So you gotta do what you gotta do. Okay, I read that already. All around you are the friends you spent the summer with. It's loud with the music and chatter of the other islanders. At first, nobody notices you. Looks like we're the last ones to arrive. Oh, I think I want to do a thumbnail for this. Let me get my girl. Got a picture. That's so us. Is it so us? is it? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Everything okay, babe? You look a little pale. How pale? Tonight's the night I proposed to Gary. I'm really nervous. I'm fine, everything's fine. Yeah, it's just a lot to take in. I really need to pee. I probably do have to pee, but yeah, it's a lot to take in. He smiles at you and pulls you into a reassuring embrace. Hey, It's alright. It's okay if you're a bit overwhelmed. There's so much going on in this room right now. Maybe we should... Princess! Oh my god, hey Chelsea. Chelsea throws up her arms and strides towards you. Chelsea! Scream her name and meet her hug, politely wave, but don't hug her. Burrow into her and pick her up in the hug. We're gonna burrow into her and pick her up in the hug. Without saying a word, you charge at Chelsea, wrap your arms around her waist, and pull her up off the ground in a tight embrace. Whee! I'm a flying fairy of love and fizz! It said fizzy, but you know, we try. I've missed you, girl! I've missed you too! Oh, and you, Gary. She turns to the others. Everybody just forgets Gary. I'm so important. Hey, Chelsea, how are... Everyone, Princess is finally here! Oh, and Gary too. The others turn to see you and cheer. There she is! I thought I was going to be the one to make the dramatic entrance. Now the reunion is really going to pick up. It's great to have the gang all back together. Chelsea turns back to you. I miss everyone being together, especially you, babe. What have you been up to? Since leaving the villa, I've been wanting to come back. Hell no. Not been up to much. I moved in with this one. You rest your head on Gary's shoulder. Aw, that's so cute. I bet you have the nicest place. You have to get me around to look at it if you want some decoration advice. I mean, exactly. Exactly. Chelsea's an interior decorator. Why didn't we just get her to help? I've been so bored without everyone. I had this one really fun job though. This guy wanted to make his house into the villa. But it was only a two up, two down terrace. And so I had to get creative. I replaced his cooker with a fire pit. And I had to fill the sitting room with sand. That cannot be good. He tried to say the villa didn't actually have sand, but I wanted a beach outing feel. There's a pause as she takes a breath. Anyway, I'm gonna go get us some drinks. See you in a bit, babes. Mommy's stuttering and stammering. Maybe I need to sit up straight. Maybe it's because I'm not in the place that I usually stream, so I'm just not okay. See you in a bit, girl. I feel like Sasha when I said that. Like, the Bratz doll Sasha. She hugs you and then practically skips off. See you, Chelsea. She's exactly as I remember. Hard to forget. The smell of fresh bread and cakes wafts in your direction as a familiar figure cuts across the crowd towards you. Did he make these delicacies? Oh, hey, look who it is. Quick as a flash, Bobby prods your nose. Don't do that. My nose is not for you to boop. You're not my man. Don't touch me. I will bite you. Boop. Bobby booped me, give him a massive hug, don't respond, sneeze suddenly. Boop him back. I'm gonna sneeze. Sneeze on him. The boop irritates your nose and you sneeze loudly towards Bobby. Whoa. Say it. Don't spray it, princess. He dusts himself off. Where's my boop? My boobs are reserved for a select few, like Princess. Gary deserves a boob. You and Bobby are like, you, Gary, and Bobby, you guys are great. You're besties. Where's his boob? If I gave them out to everyone, they wouldn't be special, would they? I don't want your boobs, sir. Gary rubs his own nose. Alright, fair enough. How are you doing, Cake Man? How'd you know? Know what? What I'm gonna call my bakery, the Cake Man. Your bakery? That's the plan. I've decided to open a shop of my own. Bobby wants to open his own bakery. I should have expected that. Do you ever get sick of cakes? It should be called Bobby's Boops. Yeah, give him a name idea. You're right. I need to call my neon sign guy first thing tomorrow morning. But look, don't let me steal you for the whole night. The others have been chomping at the bit waiting for you two. I couldn't resist that nose of yours, princess, and I'm not exactly patient. Ew, I don't want you, go away. I'll see you in a bit. He does an energetic jig towards a plate of cocktail sausages on toothpicks. I'm glad Bobby's not changed a bit. I wish he did. How many of these sausages do you think I can fit in my mouth, Chelsea? I feel like Chelsea and Bobby would also make a good couple, but they never got the chance. Not one bit. Right, who should we say hi to first? Hope, Noah, Hannah, and Shannon. Let's go. Let's go speak to my girl, Shannon. I love Shannon. You walk up to the group as Shannon is in the middle of a story. So yeah, I ran to the car, slammed the door, and sped away. I could never go back. It was a pretty tame holiday for me. See, she's wild. She's the wild one. I want to go on her adventures. Really needed a good travel partner, you know? That could have been us, Shannon. That could have been us. You should have called me up, girl. She turns to you. Oh, hey, guys. Hey, girl. So glad you made it. Hey, guys. Hannah, didn't I see something about you finishing your first draft of a novel? Yeah. Editing's really hard, though. It's worse than writing. I'm sure it'll be great. I'm just struggling with the ending at the moment. It doesn't feel right. I don't think I've been inspired properly yet. Hannah struggling to end her novel, giving a surprise twist to make everyone fall in love, make it descend into violence. Oh my gosh. No. Make everyone fall in love. We just love love. Like, literally everyone? Why not? She thinks for a moment. But why would the lake monster and judge suddenly fall in love? Trauma bond, that's why. Speaking of books, I saw that you had some pretty exciting news, Noah. Oh, it's nothing much. Don't be modest. Well, they put me in charge of revamping all the kids' areas in our local libraries. That sounds right up your street, like hard work, super dull. It sounds right up your street. They said it was because they saw how good I was with kids. I'm glad you got a new job opportunity. Good for you, Noah. And what about you, Hope? Oh, I've been designing a new range of toys at work. Ooh, look at you. I never thought I'd be the one designing stuff, but so far it seems to be doing well. Hope's designing a new toy range. That sounds like so much fun. Don't you have to be around kids for that? I mean, not really, but kinda. There's like feedback groups. Make a Gary action figure. What? Yes, give him a functional toy crane. An Islander range? That sounds hilarious. I mean, definitely don't do that if you're making it for kids, because children should not be watching Love Island, honestly. But like, if it's an adult toy line, like action figure, like collectible, then yeah, that'd be kind of cool. I never agreed to this. That's okay, Gary, I'm agreeing to it for you. Oh, if you'll excuse me, there's some mini quiches with my name on them. The rest of you chat for a little while longer before you and Gary move on. We're gonna go talk to the losers. The losers, that's so mean of me to say. You and Gary make your way over to the group who are deep in conversation. Did you guys see Arjun and Elijah's Insta story earlier? They look like they're having the best time in Malta. It's well cute. It's so obvious that they'd end up together. There were always longing glances. Henrik sees you and Gary approach. Hey, you two. I was wondering when we'd get to catch up. How has Henrik's hair gotten more lush? It looks the same to me. Lucas' face got more chiseled, also looks the same. Jacob got more buff. Sure. Marisol's eyebrow game improved. You know what? We're gonna hype up Marisol. We're gonna hype her up. She raises her eyebrow at you. Practice, babe. I thought it would be a good tool to use on clients. Your eyebrows? Practicing your eyebrows? It's the same as if Jacob flexed at people during a meeting. Jacob flexes. What does he do? Isn't he a professional bodybuilder? Why is he at meetings? I don't think bodybuilders spend a lot of time at the office. Marisol gets it. Oh, Lucas, you should tell them about what you and Henrik got up to before the reunion. What y'all get up to? Y'all in love? y'all in love? We got another gay couple? Yeah, that was an unbelievable story. What happened? It wasn't that weird, just a funny coincidence. I decided to go biking around the Alps after the show to clear my head and get away for a while. One day, I'm riding down this deserted little back country road when all of a sudden, this guy walks out of a bush in front of me. That's hilarious, actually. It was me! Mate, dramatic tension. I was getting to that. But yeah, it was Henrik. I decided to go climbing in the Alps. After bumping into each other, we decided to do a road trip. That's so cute. Friendship. I tried to teach Lucas how to climb. My bum's still sore from all the falling I did. You're braver than me, Lucas, because my ass would not be climbing the mountains. Lucas and Henrik bumped into each other in the Alps. That's so sweet. What are the odds? What are the odds? Probably too high a number to count to. That's for sure. To count to. Not count to. Why did I read it like that? And Jacob, it looks like you've been hitting the gym nonstop still. Pretty much. Had a couple of health magazines ask me to model for them. Jacob modeled for health magazines. That sounds so fun. That's so you, it hurts. I saw it. You were dressed like a bull. In the China shop, yeah, that was me. They thought it made sense after my time in the villa. That's so funny. Just drag him. And what about you, Marisol? Oh, nothing interesting. I've just been studying hard. When can I have another month-long holiday? Back to the villa, anyone? You want another month in the villa? We could go on holiday together. That'd be great. Yeah, I'd love that. Oh, you're coming with us, Gary? Okay. We chat for a while longer. Everyone seems happy to be back together again. So I'm gonna go see my girls and Rocco. You will not believe what happens in Chelsea's murder mystery party. Wild. Wild. You and Gary walk up to the middle of Rocco in the middle of his sentence. Nope. You and Gary walk up to the group as Rocco's in the middle of his sentence. And then things got really intense after I remembered about the clown suit I had in the trunk. What? What's about a clown suit? Look who's here! Oh, okay. I'll finish the story later. Princess and Gary? So glad you guys are finally here. You all fold into a large group hug. This would never happen. It's so great seeing you all. What have you been up to? Well, I arrived here a little late. Got a few down me, then danced with. I meant, while we've been out of the villa. Oh. I've actually been trying to get out of property. I've decided selling fashion is more glamorous than houses. I mean, I feel like selling houses can be pretty glamorous. There's like a whole bunch of reality shows about it. And I'm all about the glam. I mean, you are a fabulous lady, Priya. Priya's been trying to get into fashion. Yay, that's so you. It seems risky. How's it going? It's hard. Not the selling part. I've always been good at that, of course. But actually having to learn to sew to work out the designs is tough. Yeah. I'm not good at sewing. One of my best friends went to art school for fashion. She's pretty good at stuff. Damn, Priya, you're so amazing. How have we never couple up? Stop it. Probably because you grafted on every girl in the villa behind our backs? Oh, yeah. She got you there. Tell him, Lottie. So, what have you been up to, Rocco? I was just telling these guys. I've been mixing up my cocktail menu for the van. I've been trying to recreate the various fragrances. Why did I say the fragrances like that? I've been trying to recreate the various fragrances of the villa's dressing room. Ew, don't do that. Some have done better than others. Rocco's been creating new cocktails. That sounds delicious. You've not done anything else? What's the most popular? So far, the strawberry is, of course, because it's strawberry. But that could just be because it's basically a regular daiquiri. What's gone down the worst? Great question, Gary. Hairspray flavored. Who wanna drink hairspray? Ugh. Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking, though it really did taste like hairspray. Speaking of hairspray, yes, Lottie, take us away from this conversation. I've been approached by someone big to become their personal stylist. What? Who? I can't say, not yet, but they're American and you know if I said. Who do you think? Remember, this game came out like 2019, 2020. Who was big then? I'm trying to think, who was big? That would use Lottie as a stylist. I didn't really keep up with celebrities, at least not American ones, besides like Ariana Grande. What if it was Doja Cat? I could see Doja Cat and Lottie getting along. That doesn't narrow it down. But like Doja Cat came out, it was like 2020 when she got big, kind of. Right? No. No, it was definitely 2019. Yeah, I'm gonna say it's Doja Cat. That's the point. A famous American wants Lottie to be their personal stylist. It's incredible. Tell us who it is. I can see why you always look hot. Is it the president? Is it Barack Obama? Oh wait, Barack Obama was not the president then. He's the president in my head. He's my president. I can see why you always look hot. I know. I'm just glad someone's actually recognized that. Wait, does that mean you're moving to America? It does. Oh, hey, look at you. Go us. I'm gonna see you all the time, Lottie, because I'm gonna follow you around. Wait, what? Sorry, guys. This wasn't an easy decision, but I've got that wanderlust again. I mean, you're from Australia, you moved to Britain, and now you're moving to America. You're doing a lot, Lottie. Like, what is this? This is your third continent. It's your third continent, girl. And possibly, like, fourth country. And when that happens, I need to move on. Lottie's moving to America. I'm so thrilled for you. Don't forget to write. What will I do without my witch queen? No. What will I do without my witch queen? Well, for one, have a lot of fewer black clothes in your life. Well, for one, have a lot fewer black clothes in your life. Okay. I don't know why reading that. I could not process that. Something's happening with me lately, and I don't know what it is. You know what? I have a lot of black clothes. I own a lot of black clothes. So I guess that's not really true. And I guess just generally be sad, right? But let's not think about it right now. Tonight's about partying. Now that I can get behind. No, that doesn't make sense either. Now that I can get behind. I wish they would have italicized that so I can like have a way to say it not weird. Like, yeah, is most of this my fault? Yeah, but sometimes it really is the game's fault. After a few more minutes, Rocco gets distracted by canapes? I don't know what that word is. And Lottie goes to the bar. The group disperses. You look around at the islanders mingling. Right, I've waited long enough. It's time. How should I get everyone's attention? Tap the side of your glass, clap your hands loudly, shout over the noise of everyone. I'm gonna be obnoxious. You take a deep breath and yell loudly. Oi! Everyone, listen to me! Sorry if that peaked for you guys. Several islanders jump and then turn to look at you puzzled. What's up, babes? You know what? Why is Shannon here? I just thought about that. Because she wasn't like the original islander. You know, she came in during Castle Amor, and no one else is here from Castle Amor. I'm looking, I'm taking inventory. Yeah, no one here is from Castle Amor besides Shannon. Interesting. She's not even with Ibrahim. Are you doing a speech? Sort of. You turn to Gary, who looks as confused as the others. Here we go. Gary, in the time I've known you since first seeing you in the villa, ever since I fell for your silly face, since first seeing you in the villa, I've grown to love you more every day. Now I've been able to keep you out of my mind. Found it hard to not fall completely in love with you. I've found it hard not to fall completely in love with you. Is she? No way. And so, Gary, what if I pull the ring from behind his ear? That's so fucking corny. I'm gonna get down on one knee. You take a knee and pull out the ring. A chorus of gasps bounces around the room. It's happening. How'd I not see this coming? Chelsea lets out a high-pitched squeal. Will you marry me? The room is silent, waiting for Gary's answer. Gary awkwardly rubs the back of his neck. His cheeks flush red. You know I will, babe. Why did they make it seem like he was gonna say no? I don't like that. I don't like that they made that seem like he was gonna say no. He takes the ring and puts it on his own finger. In his own finger. Why did I read that like that? Okay. Whoa, that's tight. Huh? Kidding, it's perfect. The room bursts into applause. This is amazing. Me and Gary are getting married. Pull him in for a kiss, give him a massive hug, turn and cheer with the others. Pull him in for a kiss. You wrap your fingers around the back of Gary's neck and gently pull him towards you. You've kissed Gary countless times, but something about this is different. It's electrifying. You're no longer simply kissing your boyfriend. You're kissing your fiance. Ooh. Your friends run up to you, giving you both a huge group hug. Congratulations, babe. Congratulations, you two make a cute couple. You have to let me help plan your wedding. Of course. He turns to you. Let's start right away. Okay. Aren't you rushing it a bit? Yeah, this honestly does not make sense for Gary as a character, because I know he would want his mom and his nan here. Lottie is completely right. We are rushing it a bit. Why wait? We should do it as soon as possible. Yeah, I like that. Let's not mess about. Let's just do it. Could not be me. Could not be me. I mean, it could be, because I decided if I was going to get married, I would definitely elope. But if I was going to have, like, a wedding, I definitely will need time to plan it. I guess first things first. She turns to you. Who's going to be your maid of honor? And who's going to be Gary's best man? Wait, what if I want a maid of honor? Ugh, all these terms are so old-fashioned. Why do we have so many? Why not just call them best person and be done with it? That was me. I was best person at my best friend's wedding. Hey, yeah, I like that. Who do you want to be your best person, babe? For my best person, I'm in between Shannon and Chelsea. But you know what? Shannon didn't invite me to her trip. So I'm gonna go with Chelsea. Chelsea's gonna be my best girl. I wish I could pick Lottie. Honestly, if they had given me a choice for Lottie, I would have picked Lottie. I'm gonna go Chelsea. Really? Ugh. I have all the ideas. Whoa, I'm feeling faint. She stumbles back slightly. I don't like the way they made me pace that, because it doesn't feel natural. She stumbles back slightly. You okay? Yeah, I'm fine now. Just got all fluttery. What about you, babe? Who are you gonna have as your best person? I don't know. I'm stuck on my choice. You should have Ibrahim. Who do you think it should be? Really? You want me to choose? Yeah, I trust your judgment. You go over to Gary and whisper your recommendation. Why are these two the only options? These are terrible options. Gary's got beef with Lucas and Marisol. This does not make a single sense. I guess Marisol? That's a great idea. Hey, Marisol. How would you like to be my best person? I'd love to. I need to find a better dress. By the way, I can totally do weddings too. I've done one before. Oh, you're gonna ordain us? Oh, I can do ceremonies too. I got a license over the internet. I don't care what you got, Rocco. Wait, if that's an option, I want to volunteer. I'd love to marry you two. As in, make you an official couple, not like marry both of you. I mean, Priya, if you want to, I'm not opposed. I actually married two friends of mine a few summers back, so I could do it. I love this, babe. Who should do it? Well, I mean, me and Noah have history. That's kind of trifling to me to make him marry us. I mean, I think I did have Noah marry me and Kasam. I think I had either Lottie or Noah do it. I had Priya do it because I love Priya. But I'm going to pick Lottie. I've never had Rocco do it, and he's not going to start. I'm going to pick Lottie. That's who I was going to pick. Really? It doesn't seem like you would. We're sickeningly in sync, and we're not even married yet. Well, I mean, we've been dating, so it kind of makes sense that we are. So, is that it? Have we planned our wedding? I mean, it's not as simple as that, but sure. Oh, honey, you haven't even started planning the wedding. But I'm here to help. You have a lot of work cut out for you, Chelsea, especially you being my best person. She runs over to you. Princess, as your official best person, I have an amazing idea already. What if we get a carriage pulled by unicorns? Unicorns? It might be hard to find some. They're not real, babes. Yes, get me unicorns. It might be hard to find some. I heard it isn't the right season. They're not real. But I saw one once. Girl, where you see it? She pouts for a moment. Okay, how about this instead? Doves. Just loads of doves. They're like a symbol of weddings, right? No, I don't want a single bird at my wedding. We'll put that on the maybe pile. Wait, I got it. Let me design you a memories box. During the wedding, everyone can leave a note for you and Gary, which you can read afterwards. It'll be so sweet. That's actually a great idea. That is a great idea. Do I want Chelsea to make me a memory box? Yeah, make me a memory box. Yes! I'll get started right away. Where can I put my emergency glitter kit? For the rest of the night, you hold hands with Gary even when you're busy dancing. Surrounded by all the friends you made during your time in the villa, you feel content and excited for what's to come next. The wedding. Your wedding. But for now, tonight, it's about partying it up with those you love. It's me! I'm back! Just when you thought you were safe from my outstanding wit and charm, it's so great to have the gang back together, and now there's a wedding. I'm determined to make an appearance even if I don't get an invite. I wonder how I can get hold of one of those giant cakes people hide in. I want to know where you get those too, actually. Coming up, Princess Gary's wedding. Well, here we are, folks. The big day, the one we've all been waiting for. The day we'll look back on as the beginning of a whole different phase in everyone's lives. I'm finally going to get that colonic irrigation I've been dreaming about for months. Okay, that's weird. Out of place. Oh, and there's also a wedding happening. They grew up so fast. I remember when Princess and Gary were just a pair of wide-eyed, beautiful 20-somethings. And now look at them, a pair of slightly older, wide-eyed, beautiful 20-somethings. That is true. I am a 20-something. Life is wonderful. The last few weeks have been a blur of preparation. There are only a few hours left until the ceremony. Okay, so we've had weeks to prepare this. Then why? How come? How come why? How come why? Are Gary's Nan and my best friend here? Huh? Explain. They could have made a Nan sprite. They should have. They honestly should have. I don't remember if I read this, but I'm gonna read again. The last few weeks have been a blur of preparation. There are only a few hours left until the ceremony. You're in your hotel room getting ready. Chelsea flits around helping you. Here you go. She hands you a cup of tea. What's this? It's a cup of tea. You look like you needed one. She rubs your arm excitedly. Don't do that. I don't need to be touched. How's your wedding day? How are you feeling? It's your wedding day. How are you feeling? How am I feeling about getting married to Gary? I feel fine, actually. Everyone gets nervous, right? I'm freaking out. I mean, realistically, I think I would be very nervous. But you know what? Princess is cool and collected, so I feel fine, actually. Yeah, of course you do. Because you're you. Exactly. And you're marrying Gary. I guess when it's right, you just know. Yep, I've got no doubts at all. And he stayed with me after all of the stuff that I told him about what happened on Love Island. He's a keeper. He really is. Gary's the one for me. I wonder how Gary's getting on. There's a knock at the door. Hi. Look at Marisol. She looks hot. She looks hot. Hi. You haven't seen Gary anywhere by any chance? I'm not sure where he's got to. Marisol's looking for Gary. I'm sure he'll turn up. I can't believe you've lost my spouse-to-be. What if he never comes back? He'll come back. He loves you. I mean, after everything we've been through, he better come back. Unless something terrible happened to him. Not helping. How did this happen? I was doing my makeup, and when I looked around, no Gary. Well, just find him. I'll keep looking. Let's hope that's the only problem we have to deal with today. The door flies open. Oh, great. We've got a problem. Lottie, why are you here? Oh yeah, she's marrying us. I don't know why. I was like, I thought I picked Noah. My memory, terrible. Forgot Lottie was marrying us and not Noah. Let me guess, the venue burned down, a hurricane's incoming, aliens have invaded. A hurricane's incoming. Worse. Worse? Well, not worse. Different. The doves we were gonna use for the ceremony have got loose from the dove coat and they're flying around the ceremony hall. Who said doves? Because I'm pretty sure I said no doves. I don't want a single bird here. Because they're gonna poo everywhere. The doves we were gonna use for the ceremony have got loose from the dove coat and they're flying around the ceremony hall. What's a dove coat? Can't we just leave them? I knew doves were a bad idea. I know. I promise they'll be awesome during the ceremony. We just need to make sure they dramatically fly out at the right time. We're working on a way to get them back home. Don't worry though, it's under control, I promise. If it was under control, why didn't you come up here and tell me that things were not under control? Lottie leaves you and Chelsea to absorb the developments. Hopefully, it all gets sorted out. Yeah. There's another knock at the door. It's Marisol again. I've just come to give you an update. Did Gary turn up yet? Not yet. I tried to round up some people to help, but they were all focused on some sort of pigeon chase. Oh, right. Yeah. The doves got into the ceremony hall. Yikes. Okay. Well, I'll keep searching and let you know if I find Gary. Marisol leaves. I hope this all gets sorted out. I'm sure it will. Hey, I think we're just about ready to get you into your wedding gear. Wedding gear? Hold on. There's a screen in the corner. I can't wait to see what you look like. This is it. This is the outfit I'm gonna wear to marry Gary. I love the suit. I do. I'm definitely picking that one. We do love a good suit though. This was the outfit we were supposed to wear to prom. I don't know what the fuck happened. Never mind. Completely forgot about this outfit. See, look at all these other sexy ass outfits. These were supposed to show during the actual game. And this was the Ministry of Sound outfit, and they didn't show, and it's upsetting. It's upsetting. Look at all these great outfits. And then I was stuck with all the other ones. Like, yeah, they're cute, but, like, I need to be able to have all the other outfits. So let me go get my sexy little dress on. What if I married Gary in this? Like, it's a cute outfit, but it's not a wedding outfit. I could marry him in this. This is cute. This is cute. But I'm definitely marrying him in this one. Do I want to do my hair a certain particular... Ooh, there's wedding hairs? I did not know that there were wedding hairs. Of course we're picking a wedding hair. Holy wow. You... She sniffs a little bit and then bursts into tears. You just look so beautiful. There's a frantic knocking at the door. What now? It's Lottie. Good news. I managed to solve the dove problem. I thought, well, maybe they want to get married. I put together a little hand fasting ceremony for them. I thought they would appreciate some bird guests, so I lured some crows off the lawn. Why were there crows on the lawn? Why was there a murder on the lawn? But the crows just chased the doves back to their dove coat. So it got the doves out of the venue, but I didn't get to finish the ceremony. Well done, anyway. Why are you marrying fucking doves, Lottie? We've got bigger issues here. That's somehow very you. That's not all. We found Gary, too. Bless. Turns out he was in the dove coat. Don't ask me what he was doing there, but the door got locked behind him. Marisol is getting the feathers out of his hair as we speak. They found Gary. What was he doing in the dove coat? I'm so mad at him. I'm just glad he's alive. How would he have died? Dove attack? Do doves attack people? I knew someone who had to go to A&E after a goose attacked them. A goose is a very different thing. Anyway, can I borrow you for a second, Chelsea? I'd like to get your opinion on something. Sure thing. You'll be okay without me, right, Princess? Sure. Lottie and Chelsea leave. You take a moment to admire yourself in the mirror. I look so good. Gary isn't gonna know what hit him. There's a knock at the door. Who is it? It's Gary. Is Lottie there? Girl, why would Lottie be here? This is my room. Oh, no, it's just me. Are you in your wedding outfit? Can I see? Gary wants to come in. It'd be nice to get some alone time with him before the wedding. Yeah, I'm opening the fucking door. Watch me have spent all my fucking gems. I'm gonna be upset. Because then I'm gonna have to buy some more gems. You open the door. Gary breaks into a huge smile. Wow, I don't know what I was expecting, but why am I stuttering? Wow. How is this real life? I keep thinking that, or any moment, Lottie or someone is gonna shake me awake and I'll be back on the daybeds in the villa. Because I definitely had this dream once or twice. Ooh, okay. And now I'm here. I really, really hope I don't wake up. Gary says, this feels like a dream. Let's make the most of it, our time then. This is better than a dream. I had a horrible dream last night. Oh my gosh. I'm not gonna ruin him. But, you know, I have nightmares often. This is better than the dream. It's definitely better than the dream I had the other day, where my socks came alive and tried to eat my feet. At least it wasn't your pants. Ouch. I don't know what that joke is supposed to mean, but okay. Gary puts his arm around you and presses his body close to yours. By the way, why did you go into the dove coat? Oh, that. I just wanted a little bit of alone time. To chill out a bit, you know? Yeah, I get that. It's nice to be here with you. I should get going. Before you go, kiss me, tell me you love me, tell me a joke. Give me the funnies. What do you get if you cross Gary and Princess? I don't know, what do you get? I don't know either. Wanna find out in a couple of hours? Oh my gosh, not him trying to make babies with me. I thought you were gonna say an internal love. Internal. I thought you were gonna say an eternal love or something. That too. He brushes your cheek gently, then leaves you with the memory of his touch lingering on your skin. Gross. I don't want that. Well, it's finally here. The moment you've all been waiting for. Doesn't Princess look gorgeous? I'm so dumb. I meant to get a picture of myself in the wedding outfit. You know what? I'll do it later. I'll replay the wedding episode on my own time and I'll do it then. For the thumbnail. I suppose Gary doesn't look too bad either. I can't even decide whose head I'm going to replace with mine when I edit the wedding photos alone in my room later. Is this mic still on? You step out into the aisle and see Gary standing there. In fact, he's all you see. You're vaguely aware of a room full of hushed former islanders, all eyes on you, but it's a blur. You walk towards him. Hey, fancy meeting you here. Wanna do something wild? Like, get married? Exactly what I was thinking. Queens, kings, islanders. Why are you so fucking extra? I'm so glad I picked her. We've gathered here to celebrate the love of two very special people, Princess and Gary. Everyone goes into the villa hoping to find love, but it can be a tough environment in many ways. You learn a lot about yourself in there, but true love finds a way to overcome that. And what you're looking at here, guys, is true love. Sure, it wasn't exactly an easy road for them to get here, but they were always gonna make it. It's fate, pure and simple. Now, I think Gary has some words he'd like to say. Gary gets a crumpled piece of paper out of his pocket. I was thinking about what I wanted to say here. A vow is like a promise, and I want to promise you the world because you deserve it. I do deserve it. I do deserve the world, and so do you. But our love isn't based on overblown stuff like that. It's real. So, I want to make some real promises. I promise to love you forever. That's an easy one to keep, but I thought I should start with it. That's actually so sweet. I promise to always show you how I feel about you. Not just with words when we're alone, but with actions. I want everyone to know how much I love you. I promise to always make you feel like you're the most important person in the room. This is so nice. I want somebody to feel that way about me. And I promise to always be open to trying new things. You know what I mean. And I promise to... He's interrupted by a loud ringing. Whose is that? It's me. He pulls his phone out of his pocket and looks at the screen. Put that away? No, I really have to answer it. It's Nan. He answers it. I finally we get some Nan content, but like, this is the Nan content we deserve. Hi, Nan. Yes, actually, it's my wedding, actually. Oh, right. Yeah, I'll ask. Nan wants to speak to you. Is that cool? Gary's Nan wants to speak to me. I'd love to finally get to speak to his Nan. He hands you the phone. The voice that blares out of it is warm, but with steel edges. Princess, is that you, dear? It's Gary's Nan. Hi, Nan. It's so lovely to finally get to speak to you, dear. You're telling me we've been boyfriend and girlfriend for a full entire year, and he has not taken me to meet his Nan yet. He's trifling. Gary, do we need to have a talk in private about something? You know what? I'm gonna be on Gary's side. Maybe he wanted things to calm down after Love Island ended because I was being trifling as hell on that show. And he wanted space for his Nan to forget. I got it. I understand now. It's so lovely to finally get to speak to you, dear. It was nice to hear Gary's voice too, of course, but I speak to him every day. So, how are you feeling? I was so nervous at my wedding that I spent all day in the loo. I think I lost 5 stone that day. How much is a stone? Like, compared to a pound? We're gonna look this up right now. How much is a stone? How much is a stone? In pounds. 14 pounds. 5 times 14, that's 70 pounds? Girl, what? That's a lot of pounds. Ooh, that's kind of scary, girl. You need to go to get some medical help for that. I feel great. I love Gary so much. Yes, well, don't tell him that. It'll go to his head and it'll swell up to the same size as the rest of him. And that's the last thing he needs, the big lung. Nan, I'm sorry, I couldn't make it. My knees betrayed me. I'd call the police on them, but I'm no snitch. Oh, What are these jokes, Nan? What's she saying? See, this is how me and Princess are different. I would've put that bitch on speakerphone. Cause ain't no way I'm putting someone's phone up to my ear. I'm not doing that. All my conversations on the phone, on speaker, or they're in earbuds. Only way I'll talk to you on the phone. She just said she's sorry she couldn't make it. Yeah. Doctor says she couldn't walk for a while. How old is she, like 90? Nan's voice barks in your ear again. So, how are things in the bedroom department? Not too nervous, I hope. This is an inappropriate conversation. I can't believe Gary's Nan asked me that. Not nervous at all, maybe a little nervous. It'll be our first time. That's definitely not true. As much as Gary would like to believe that this will be our first time, it won't be. I'm not nervous. Confident. That's good to hear. Men like a confident woman, do they? So I heard. You'll be grand. Have a lovely day, dear, and if you need any bedroom tips, you know where to turn. What? Why would I get bedroom tips from Gary's grandmother? That feels disgusting. Absolutely not. Okay. Wow. Gary, do we need to have a talk? Do we need to go to therapy again? And remember what they say. Next door, don't care if you hang the cat's whiskers out to dry. What? What does that mean? I'll remember that, Nan. Bye. Ta-ra, dear. What did she say? You went very red at the end there. Nothing. Oh, look, hey, girl. That's my girl, Shannon. What's up, girl? Well, that can be my last vow. I promise not to let my nanny eat you alive. It's my turn now. Okay, oh my gosh. You clear your throat. Gary, I love you more than I love sunshine. And I always will. And I promise to always put our team first. Listen to what you have to say. Surprise you. I'm going to put our team first. Because you're the most important person in my life, you mean more to me than I ever thought possible. You fill in a part of me I didn't know was missing. You're the most important person in my life. Gary smiles at you and squeezes your hand. Finally, you hear Lottie say the words. Well, Gary and Princess, you've come here today in the presence of so many close friends to be joined together as one. And it gives me great pleasure to say, I now pronounce you husband and wife. The ensembled islanders all shout kiss. You and Gary's lips meet and you kiss like you've never kissed before. The doves finally get their time to shine, wings flapping as they fly around you. Disgusting. I hate birds so much. Gary and I are married. Race him outside, whispers. I'm gonna whisper something in his ear. I'm not carrying this man down the aisle. You lean in and put your lips to his ear. That's his job. His job is to carry me down the aisle. What should I say? I can't wait to get you alone. I really, really love you. I want a divorce. just cause. I know you too well to know you're serious. Damn it. Turns out there are downsides to being the love of someone's life. I would never do this to my partner in real life. I would never whisper, I want a divorce. At my wedding, maybe the next day as a joke, but not at the wedding. That's too serious for me. You both laugh. You take each other's hand and walk out of the door and into your new life. Look at us. Yeah, we're cute. Wow, okay. All the guests are gathered in the reception venue. They cheer and clap as you enter. Throw your bouquet. Person who catches the bouquet is the next to get married. Who should I aim for? I'm aiming it for Noah. You cunningly toss the bouquet so it lands right in Noah's hands. He smiles shyly. Lottie tops the glass with a spoon. It wouldn't be a wedding if we didn't hear from the people who knew the couple best. Because of the unusual way that we all got to know each other, they decided to give a joint speech. Everyone give it up for Chelsea and Marisol. Chelsea taps the microphone. I love how they're kind of matching. Like, my wedding party colors be pinkish peach? No. But they're living it up. They're doing it. Hello. Is this thing on? I've always said that the most important thing in any relationship is support. I've been thinking about the science of love. The stages of love have been defined by scientists. First, there's lust, which is purely physical attraction. Chelsea and Marisol look at each other. Yeah. As I was saying, a good partner supports their partner like a perfectly fitted bra. Except, in a great marriage, the boob also supports the bra. It's mutual. Chelsea leans towards you and whispers conspiratorially. Gary is the boob, because you'll always be my bra.
Not her shading him during my wedding.
Anyway, the science of love. After lust, there's attraction. That's where you can't stop thinking about them. Your brain has increased levels of dopamine and norepinephrine, but lower serotonin. I don't know how to say that word. I've never seen that word ever in my life. Makes you get just a little bit obsessive. A little bit. I'm hella obsessive. But that's not really love either. You know what? I think this is starting to get confusing. Yeah, it is. You should just let Chelsea make the speech. You're done. Yeah, I've forgotten where I was going. Chelsea lifts her glass. Princess and Gary are amazing and amazing together. I'm excited to see where they go next. To their next adventure. Everyone toast you. Right, cake time. The cake is enormous, bigger than you've ever dreamed possible. It's an incredible work of art with rosettes and flourishes adorning it from bottom to top. I made it. Took me ages too. I love how they gave Bobby a kilt. I love how he gets a good themed outfit and Gary's wearing the worst outfit ever. Like, sir, this is our wedding. Why aren't you in a tuxedo? It's amazing. Yeah, you did a great job. Someone hands you a knife. Oop, that's a bad idea. Should not hand me a knife ever. Time to cut a slice of cake. Unless I kind of want to eat the whole thing. I'm pretty sure I could. Gary would be up for it. We're a team now. Are you okay, princess? You're just standing there holding the knife. Yeah, it's kind of scary. Gary, want to eat the whole cake with me? Can I just say, as the baker, I want to see this more than I've ever wanted to see anything. Wow, what is it with you and eating the whole cake? Are you serious? Do I want to eat the whole cake? Hold on. Less talking, more eating. I do want to eat this whole cake. You and Gary look at each other, then at the assembled guests. We've decided that we're going to eat the cake. I mean, isn't that the point of the cake? No, we're going to eat the cake. All of it. Your first act as a married couple is going to be eating a whole cake. Can't think of anything better. Okay, everyone. Clear them a space. This is happening, people. The crowd forms a wide circle around you, Gary, and the cake. What's our approach here? There's only one way. We should take our time, just go for it. Let's get silly with it. You scoop up some frosting and smear it on Gary's face. She wipes it off and eats it. She? Gary, you changed your pronouns again? Sir. That's a good cake, but that's not a very efficient way of eating it. Give me some of that cake and I'll show you how to eat it. I mean, you've watched me eat a whole cake before, so I don't know why you think I can't eat this whole cake now. Should I feed her some cake? Okay, I guess Gary's female now. Yeah, super cute. Steal some off her fork instead. Flick some cake at her. You're like, yeah, I'm gonna feed Gary some cake. You huddle the fork with a blob of cake on it. Gary leans in with a grin and closes her mouth around it. Minutes pass. Your stomach is full of cake and frosting, but there's still more than half left. We might not make it. Keep going. Give up. Get everyone involved. This is a cake. We're doing it. You address the crowd of islanders. Guys, Gary and I made it this far in our relationship mostly because we're super amazing. But also because of our friends. That's you. And just like our relationship, this cake is really, really great. But we need some help. What do you say? Up for it? I'm sorry about the ad. I needed to go buy some more gems. And I didn't want to get doxxed, so very sorry. There's a pause, and then as one, the crowd surges forward towards the cake. I thought I'd have enough gems. I really did. Seconds later, it's completely gone. We did it. Yeah, we did. Together. You guys are the best friends anyone could ask for. I mean, I could definitely ask for better friends. I can't believe you just did that. I can't believe you did either. Couple of the century. Okay, Pri, I see you. I see you in the dress. Okay. The DJ starts playing you and Gary's song. Everyone goes out to the edge of the dance floor. What would me and Gary's song be? I'm trying to think. I don't know why Pawn the Replay is in my head. I guess that's me and Gary's, that's our song. It's Pawn the Replay by Rihanna. That's our first song. I'm so glad we chose a song that's up-tempo and fun, that's slow and romantic, that has a novelty dance we learned. We're not learning any novelty dances. It's up-tempo and fun. You head out onto the dance floor and start tearing it up. You and Gary bust out every move you know. She's a great dancer. She makes it look easy. Gary, I can't. They gave him female pronouns. The song comes to an end and you pull away from each other slightly breathless. The DJ starts playing a familiar song. What? Is it Pawn to Replay again? Are we playing that again? No way. Remember this one? Tune! Everyone piles into the dance floor and soon everyone is dancing together. Who should I dance with? Hannah, Chelsea, Lucas, Priya, Bobby, Lottie. We're gonna dance with Lottie. Hey girl! Hey, I have to say, I was pretty nervous about the whole celebrant thing, but it went okay in the end, didn't it? It sure did. It went more than okay. You killed it. What? Who told you about the... Oh, wait. You mean figuratively. What the fuck, Lottie? What did you kill? Did you kill one of the crows outside? Or one of the doves? Phew. I'm glad you think so. So... this is it, I guess. Tomorrow you'll be off to start your new life. You too, right? Exciting times. You can't quite read Lottie's expression. Yeah, exciting times. Who should I dance with? Let's dance with Chelsea.
Why did that feel? That felt a little empty. Like, Lottie is gonna miss me too much.
You grab Chelsea's hands and twirl her around. She giggles. We made it, hon! Well, you made it. It was a team effort, babes. I meant what I said, you know. We'll always be each other's bras. Even after we've been washed a few thousand times and we're kinda gray and wrinkly. I love you, princess. Like, for real. Same girl. I couldn't say I love her back. Interesting. Commitment issues. You hug. Who should I dance with? Priya, of course. You and Priya spot each other across the dance floor and squeal excitedly. You did it, babes! Like, look at her dress! Like, why is this sexier than her own dress, you know? Like, her original dress. You did it, babes! How are you feeling? Like, I can't believe it really happened. I hadn't really thought about what comes next, but it's pretty exciting. I mean, is there anything that really happens after you get married, except for a whole bunch of legal stuff? She smiles. Good luck with everything in the future. Who should I do? Do I have to keep dancing with everybody? Okay, we're gonna do Bobby next. Bobby dances across the floor towards you. His moves get more and more ridiculous as he goes. He's a clown. Congratulations. You and Gary are like the perfect cake ingredients. I can't wait to see what kind of cake you make together. Why is Marisol not here? Bobby smiles warmly at you. Like, why is Hannah the option? I feel like Marisol should be the option. You're one of my favorite people, princess. Take care, yeah? You're gonna go to Hannah. You touch Hannah's shoulder. She turns around and laughs in delight. Hey, girl, so I hear you got married? Yep. This is like the end of a movie or a really good book. She sighs wistfully. For a moment, she looks a little sad. You're one of the most amazing people I know. You really deserve this. I love how after all the shit she was talking in the villa and how much shit I was talking about her in the villa, we're just cool. We put it all behind us. We're friends now. It looks like she wants to say something else, but she cuts herself off abruptly. I'm gonna get a drink. You have a good night, okay? Hannah disappears into the crowd. We got Lucas to dance with. Hey, you. Having a good night? I love how he's on theme. One thing about Lucas, he will be on theme. The best. It was an incredible wedding. I know. Gary is obviously a great person. But you tell her from me that if she ever hurts you, she'll have an enemy for sure. I can't with the pronouns. That's sweet. I think. Have a great night, princess. You deserve it. I love how he's still carrying a torch for me. I love that for us. More people crowd around to talk to you, and you lose yourself in a whirlwind of dancing, friends, and laughter. No matter how exciting tomorrow may be, part of you wishes the night would never end and that you could stay here with these people forever. Better tell life to get on your level. Listen, I had to end stream earlier because I ran out of gems. And I wanted to do all the gym scenes, so I had to end stream, and now here we are. Technically, we're like an hour, 10 minutes into the entire stream. Previously on Love Island. Yeah, oh no, I definitely thought I had enough, but I did not. Princess and Gary tied the knot. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You just finished your work day so early. So early, Ack. And Princess got her cake. And Princess and her cake got up close and personal. Cake! I'm suddenly very glad I didn't get sent to the right wedding. Hold on. What do you mean you didn't get sent to the right wedding? Whose wedding were you at? You weren't even invited to this wedding. I think Princess might have eaten me. Maybe. I do bite. Not on purpose. Maybe on purpose. I hope. It probably will be on purpose. Someone passed me a tissue. Coming up. It's the night of the wedding. What do you think happens on a wedding night? You look stunning, Princess. Thank you. Thank you, Gary. Most of the guests have clambered into their taxis or gone upstairs to bed. So is this a hotel? It's just you, Chelsea, Marisol, and Lottie dancing the night away. This is the best party ever. You're all arm in arm together on the dance floor. The buzz of the party pushes the five of you into the early hours of the morning. This is not true. I would probably be the first one to leave my own wedding. Because I don't like parties. Another dance? Yes. Marisol and Lottie drag Gary back to the center of the dance floor. Chelsea links arms with you and gestures to the side. She holds herself up by leaning on your shoulder. My heels are killing me. I bet they are, girl. Take them off. Another thing about me, I'm not going to be wearing heels all day. I'll wear them during the actual ceremony, and then the bitch is coming off. I will walk around barefoot if I have to. I actually did walk around barefoot at my friend's wedding that I went to. I took my heels off. I was walking on gravel with my bare feet because I would rather walk on gravel than wear heels. I need to sit down. You wander over to the booth and slump into it together. Have you opened any of your wedding presents yet? I haven't. Chelsea looks over to Gary. Okay, I think you should open mine, like, right now. What did you get me, Chelsea? Chelsea runs over to the table with stacks and stacks of presents. Chelsea carries over a pile of beautifully wrapped parcels and a little bag. That's loads of gifts, Chelsea. I couldn't resist. Chelsea's such a... She's such a great friend. This sort of explains the first gift. She hands you an envelope and you open it. The front of the card says, "The best thing to hold on to life is each other." Oh, that's sweet. Inside is a message from Chelsea. "Dear Princess and Gary, when you trip over love, it is easy to get up. But when you fall in love, it is impossible to stand again. I hope this present makes the floor more comfy. Big hugs, Chelsea, XXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXXX right. Thank you, Chelsea. You wait till you see your presents. Forgot. There's multiple. I love presents. I love gifts. She passes you a parcel. You unwrap it and find a large, shaggy rug. It matches your color scheme perfectly. Chelsea has given me and Gary a rug. Is there a pug in there too? That's so thoughtful. That's so random. It's missing a quote on it. I found one rug that just said, get naked on it. Okay. But it was actually a bath mat, and that didn't really go with the theme. I thought you could put it in your new home with Gary. It's super comfy and perfect for falling in love on. Falling in love on? Interesting. She passes you another parcel. Open the next one. You rip off the wrapping paper. It's a mug with words. To the world, you are one person, but to me, you are the world. That's so sweet. Oh my god, Chelsea. I mean that, babe. Chelsea. Chelsea says that I'm her world. You're my world, Chelsea. That's so sweet. That's so sweet. I try. Okay, you got two more presents left. I can't believe how much you bought me. I mean, it doesn't seem that expensive based on what we've gotten so far. But, like, thank you anyway, Chelsea. I really love it. You deserve it all, babe. I do. I do deserve it all. Open this one first because, like, it goes with the other ones. She passes you a parcel. It's quite squishy. You unwrap it quickly. It's a toy pug. Chelsea got me a rug, a mug, and a pug. We talked about this. We talked about this on the show. Thank you so much, babe. You should be a poet, hon. I'm so glad it's not a real pug. Thank you so much, babe. No thanks needed. You totally deserve all the rugs, mugs, and pugs in the world. I mean, that's a lot. She hands you the last gift in a striped white and pink bag. Another present? This is your final gift, I promise. You pull a beautiful bra. Not the bra. You pull a beautiful bra out of the bag. It's the perfect size. How does she know? How does she know? I just wanted you to know that I'll always be here to, like, support you whenever you need it. Chelsea pulls her top to the side slightly. Her bra is identical. I can't. And now we're, like, officially bra sisters. Chelsea bought us matching bras as well. You know what? I did that with a friend. We got matching underwear. We got matching underwear when we were younger. Matching bras. We're going to be bra sisters for life. Thank you. Bras are expensive. Bras are expensive. Especially if you're above a, like, triple D. If you're above double D, actually. Bras are expensive, but, like, if you're above that size, impossible to find a bra in store, like, at any, like, major store. So you have to go to the specialty store, and the specialty stores are expensive as fuck. You bought me too much stuff. We're gonna be bra sisters for life. I wouldn't have it any other way. Chelsea looks at you grinning. You're seriously the best friend I've ever had. I love you, babe. I should hug her and tell Chelsea I love her too. Ask to be the best person at her wedding. Yana, say you're ready for big. I'm gonna hug her back. She deserves this. You wrap your arms around Chelsea and tightly hug her. I love you too. Hugs, mugs, pugs, and rugs. That's what every bra sister needs. Bras are way too damn much. They are. They are, act. You would know, wouldn't you? You wear bras. You wear bras, right? Gotta hold them natural D's up. I would know. Thank you so much for choosing me to share this special day with you. Gary, Marisol, and Lottie come over. Gary rests his hand on your shoulder and gives you a gentle squeeze. Ready for bed, gorgeous? Yeah. No, it's not bedtime yet. Lottie, he was not talking to you, so I need you to butt out. Let's take this party upstairs to your room. We're not having an orgy. Yes, we're not doing this, okay? I want you guys to know that now. Great idea. Let's do it. Guess the party continues in our room then. It shouldn't. It should not continue in our room. Tell them to leave. Kick them out. You follow your friends upstairs. Everyone piles into the room. It's pretty spacious, but there's not a lot of room for everyone to sit other than the giant bed. If you don't go bra shopping with your girl or hold the sample paper at Bath and Body Works, then need to step up your game. I went like underwear shopping with one person before, and it was my first boyfriend, and I was like skinnier then. Like, I had like big boobs then too, but like it's different because I could find my size at the bra shop. But like now it's kind of hard. I will admit it's still kind of hard. But yeah, I've only went like underwear shopping with one boyfriend, and we're definitely not together anymore. I want to go underwear shopping again. I think it'd be cute, but you know, who has the money? Not me. I'm poor and broke. But good on you, Ak. Yes, go to the store with your girl and help her shop for underwear. It's cute. It's a cute experience. Everyone piles into the room. It's pretty spacious, but there's not a lot of room for everyone to sit other than the giant bed. So you all get in it together. Get out of my bed. I see a chair right here. Go sit over there. Victoria's Secret has pretty good deals, like the 3 for $25 or whatever. Yeah, I know. I know about Victoria's Secret. Trust me. I know. I just can't shop there. It's like we're in the villa again. Except none of you are staying in here overnight. Tell them, Gary. So don't get too comfy. I really miss it. Hanging out with you all. Oh my gosh. I really miss it. Hanging out with you lot all the time was the best. Why was I struggling? Yeah, can't believe you are both off traveling without us. Yeah, I know. It feels like we've only just reunited. Where are you two going? You haven't picked anywhere yet.
I need to change my position that I'm sitting in. My legs need to stretch out.
Yeah, we were gonna book it tonight and get a last minute deal. That's terrible. You need to book that shit in advance, Gary. How dare you put this off to the last minute? I don't mind where we go. As long as you're with me, princess. What should we do for a honeymoon, sunbathing in Mexico, ski down the Alps, log cabin in Wales? Let's go to Mexico. Mexico. Sure, Mexico would be amazing. Here's a crazy idea. Wouldn't it be hilarious if we came too? The others all turn and look at you both seriously. It's like we're back at the villa. Gary looks at you. What do you reckon? Usually I say no, but I'm gonna say you should all come with us. For real? Yeah, why not? Yes, Mexico, here we come! Because I'm gonna be so sad about Lottie leaving. She's like my second best friend. Woo, yes, holiday. Gary laughs. Okay, but we're not sharing a bed like this at night. Chelsea yawns. And on that note, we should probably be off to bed. The others are going to bed. Give them all a hug goodbye. Say thank you to Chelsea for the gift. Now I can get on top of Gary. Okay, I'm gonna tell them bye. Everyone hugs each other goodnight. Thank you for like letting us be a part of it all on your big day. I love like who I picked. I really wish I could have picked Ibrahim for Gary, but they only gave me Ibrahim, and Ibrahim is not my mate, okay? He's not my bestie. And I would have loved to pick Shannon, but she didn't take me on holiday with her, so she's not bestie anymore. The order of besties has changed. It's Chelsea, Lottie, and then Shannon. Then it's Shannon. But like, me and Marisol had so much beef in the villa. I think it's absolutely hilarious that I chose her to be Gary's best mate, especially because Gary chose her in the beginning, kind of. I don't know. Something about that is just like ironic. Gary and Marisol hug. You're all welcome. Yeah, it was amazing. Slowly they make their way out of the room. goodbye for now, folks. We love you. Night. Night, everyone. You shut the door and turn around to look at Gary. Gary breathes out a sigh of relief. Finally, honestly saying, this is the first time we've been alone since we became Mr. and Mrs. Or Mrs. and Mrs. apparently, to you, Gary, since you're using female pronouns. He grins at you. Shall we get into something a little more comfortable? Yeah. See, look at all these outfits I could have been having, but I've been kept from them because Love Island didn't want to give me the hot fucking outfits. So which one am I gonna wear? I'm gonna wear this one. This one's cute. This one's sexy. Not me spinning gems when I don't need to. Gary smiles at you while loosening the cork on the champagne bottle. Gary pours a glass of bubbly and hands it to you. Sir, you know I prefer margaritas. Why are you giving me champagne? You look stunning, princess. By the way, I don't want there to be any kind of pressure tonight. We're married and that's all that matters. Gary, we've literally had sex so many times. Please stop this nonsense. Oh, let's have a look through the post box that thing Chelsea got us. Good plan. Gary gets up and tips the letters out. What does this one say? Hi, Princess and Gary. It's the best adventure of your life. Love your favorite snake, Rocco. Rocco left us a note. He's so right. I love adventures with Gary. He's still a snake in my eyes. I love adventures with Gary. I can't wait for all the adventures with you. Same. You grab another letter out of the box. Be warned, marriage is a grim mara. Jokes. I love you both. Love, Marisol. Marisol, shut up. Marisol said that marriage is grim. Nothing is grim with Gary by my side. She's right. It's going to be grim. Hope no one marries Marisol in a rush. Gary frowns. They were joking. It's an anagram of marriage. Listen, I don't give a fuck. Oh, right. My bad. Gary, you know I'm a hater, okay? Don't pretend that you don't know this. You literally married me. Gary pulls out another card. Enjoy your big day, Big Daddy. Big Daddy? Who's that? It's the bird, but also it's Lucas. I've got no idea. You pick up a few more letters. Hey babes, this coupon entitles you to one free in-depth tarot reading, a full 78 card spread, the works. It'll change your life and only take about 5 hours. Love, Lottie. She didn't say love, Lottie, but I know she meant it. I know she meant to say love, Lottie. Also, of course, Lottie, I'm taking you up on that. I'm taking you up on that because you know I'm a tarot girl. I totally don't want to get ahead of myself, but I can't wait to decorate the baby room. Like, if you're into the whole baby thing. I've got loads of ideas for themes, constellations, forest plants, France. Love you both. Chelsea. I love it, Chelsea. I love it. I made you a Just Married mixtape, but I forgot to bring it. I'll send you the MP3s. I love it. I love Kasam so much. I miss him. I knew you two were going to get together in the end. It was obvious from day one. All the best for the future, Shannon. Shannon, girl, I miss you. It is I, Big Rocco. Big time Rocco. The big snake. Thank you for the love on this most day. Keep it snaky. He's drawn a snake around the edge of the card. I think Rocco had a fair few too many shakes tonight. There are like four from him here. They only get worse. The last one is just a big wobbly smiley face. Yeah, moving on. Gary grabs another. I dare you to kiss the person next to you. Who is this? Oh, it's a dare. Who could this be? That feels like a Priya. That feels like a Priya one. But it could also be someone else. Oh, it's a dare. What is it with these people implying truth or dare? Or hope. It could also be hope. Gary has a cheeky glimmer in his eye. Should I do the dare? Yeah, just kiss Gary all over. You lean in towards Gary and start kissing him. His chest, his neck, his cheeks. Finally, you make it to his lips. Gary leans in. A fervent passion sweeps over you. You're desperate for each other's touch. His hands are all over you, your back, your arms. After a heavy makeout session, Gary eventually pulls away. Glad I put that one in. Cheeky. Oh my gosh, it was Gary. Gary's trifling for doing that. You roll your eyes and put the letterbox back in the corner. So, let me make a little private toast to us. I wanted to say firstly how happy I am to be with you. I knew, like, since I met you that we'd get together. Did you? And I can't wait for the future with you. Gary raises his glass. What do you, like, think is the most important thing for our future together? What is the most important thing for me, traveling, career, babies, bits? Babies! I can't wait to have all the babies! Yes, to all the babies! You clean glasses and take a sip. It's time to practice, Gary. Pull it out. I should tell Gary he's gorgeous, tell Gary you love him. Whisper naughty things I will do to Gary. You gotta whisper the naughty things. I want to show you a good time. You lean in and whisper in Gary's ear. His eyes grow wider as you explain in dirty detail your plans for tonight. That sounds so damn hot. Gary's eyes are full of excitement. Oh, hang on. You've got something in your hair. Yeah, it's my hairpiece. Looks like a little bit of cake. You know what, Gary? You're a little bit of cake. Gary pulls it out for you. He points to the beautiful bath in the corner of the room. Shall we make use of this place and share a bath together? Are you saying I'm filthy? No, but it could be fun. And it has been a long, hard day. Do I want to share a sexy, steamy bath with Gary? Of course. I bought these gems for a reason. You turn the taps on. Let's have a bath together. The window quickly steams up. As the bath fills up, Gary draws a smiley face on the window. So, what makes your perfect bath? What are my bath requirements? Really hot, essential oils and lots of candles, all of the bubbles and bath bombs. I only ever bathe in milk. That's wild. That's crazy. Bath bombs, bubbles. You're in luck. They've got some in here. I like the candles too. I don't really need essential oils. I don't feel like they belong unless they're in like a diffuser. But I love bubbles. Gary pours in a whole bottle of bubble liquid and some bath bombs in. I don't love looking at bubbles like for a long time because circles kind of freak me out a little bit. Just a little bit. I've never used a bath bomb before. It's so colorful. The bubbles overflow the bath and spill onto the floor. The air fills with sweet scents. Gary is wearing his clothes and dress yourself. Slowly tell him to wear his clothes in the bath. That's wild. Tell him to strip for you. Strip. Gary slowly takes off his clothes. Like what you see? I do. You follow suit and take off your clothes. Now we're naked. Gary steps into the bath. You sit in between his legs. Not me wearing a swimsuit. They couldn't have just like clouded around my body. Gary splashes you a little bit by kicking his feet. I should splash him back, tell him to behave, pretend to be a pirate. Ahoy, matey. Ahoy. Do you want to walk my plank? Oh. I was not expecting that. You both relax into each other. Bubbles pop under your touch. I wish you could stay like this forever. In the bath, you don't have any responsibilities except to get clean. A bit like it was back in the villa. I miss having no responsibilities, can't wait for our real life to begin. Wish we could have got dirtier in the villa. Nah. I can't wait for our real life to begin. You're right. Neither can I. You listen to the slow trickle of water from the tap. But it's so peaceful here. Gary smiles at you longingly. I love you. And I really can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I should tell him. Tell him you love him, splash Gary, call Gary soapy? Soppy? I think that's soppy. Tell him I love him back. I love you too, gorgeous. I love you too, beautiful. Gary envelopes you in his arms. We're gonna make out, obviously. Obviously we're gonna make out. No, don't tell him that. Why wouldn't I tell my man that I love him? He needs to know that he's the most important person in my life and I'm done cheating on him. Now, let's make out. Gary takes your face in his hands and kisses you. Hard. You slide around so you are on top of him.
You could have held all the power and you gave in. What do you mean, all the power? There is no power dynamic between us.
Warmth spreads through you as Gary explores your body with his lips. Wrapped up in one another, you feel weightless. Your head is spinning full of hot, heavy emotions. You look over at the bed. Bed? Gary nods. Bed. Are we gonna dry off? Or are we just gonna, okay, and I'm gonna get back in the pajamas I was just wearing? That doesn't seem good.
Make him chase you forever?
I mean, he's always going to have to chase me because I'm wild. I'm wild like that. I'm only slightly domesticated. I'm an outside cat. You lie beside each other, looking into one another's eyes. You both smell amazing after the luxurious. Why did I say luxurious? Luscious bath. You're breathtaking. It's our wedding night. Do I want to do bits with Gary? Jump on top of him, pull him on top of me. Let's go to sleep. Pull him on top of me. You pull Gary on top of you. He pulls you in closer. You melt into one another. Your body's perfectly in sync. There is a familiarity to his touch as you frantically find each other under the covers. You know what each other wants. You know how to please each other. I'm glad we have this moment. Gary shudders at your touch. He kisses you all over with more fire than ever before. It's like you're discovering each other's bodies again for the first time. How many first times have we had? Oh, wow. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself, Gary. Breathless and hot, you slowly slink back into each other's arms. What a night. The best night ever. Gary smiles at you. I should kiss Gary goodnight, demand to be little spoon, demand to be big spoon. I'm gonna be little spoon. Sure, babes. Whatever you want. You settle down in each other's arms, listening to the sound of Gary's soft breathing. You both drift off to sleep, holding each other close. How nice, how cute. You slowly wake up in Gary's arms. Gary's eyes flutter open.
That was about the average time it takes. What do you mean? You mean like just in general, that's how long it takes for you? Good to know. Tell him to go get waffles. Maybe he is getting waffles. We don't know what's happening yet. Let's continue the story. Let's watch.
Morning, beautiful. He strokes your hair. You can't help yourself. The sight of Gary makes you smell instantly. Morning, gorgeous. Let's more ruffle his hair. You ruffle Gary's hair. He laughs. Gary stretches his arms and wraps them around you. Is he like Mr. Fantastic? He has like stretchy arms. Ready to face the world together? Am I ready to face the world? No, let's stay in bed. You flop back into bed. Gary strokes your shoulder softly. Come on, sleepyhead. Let's do this. Gary gets up suddenly and starts packing your suitcases. We've got to get packing if we're gonna make our flight. You can hear a knock at the door. We're ready. Not them being in their wedding outfits. Yeah. Let us in. Y'all couldn't have gotten into like your regular clothes. Everyone piles into the room carrying suitcases. You guys could have literally met us in the lobby. You don't have to be here. Mexico, here we come. I'm not even dressed yet. Marisol throws a pile of clothes at you. Come on, do your magical get dressed in a few seconds thing. Yeah, we got a plane to catch.
I love that little slight like fourth wall break. I can tell this is gonna be an interesting honeymoon with you lot.
Congratulations, Gary and Princess, on your wedded bliss. I wish you a super duper lovely life together. Send me a postcard for Mexico. Now, can someone please get me out of this cake? Congratulations, Islanders. We really hope you enjoyed your wedding. Thank you for being such a brilliant group of people. Your love and support for our games is what makes it all worthwhile. Plenty more awesome stuff to come later in the year, so stay tuned and stay hydrated. Lots of love, the Fusebox team. P.S. Feel free to play through the wedding episode again if you make some different choices. Maybe there are some surprises in store.
Thank you all for coming to this stream. I really appreciate the support. Thank you for lurking. Thank you for chatting. Thank you for not doing any of those. Thank you for showing up and then leaving because I wasn't for you. That's okay. That's okay. Either way, we had a stream. So, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, week, month, year, and life. And I hope to see you next stream. Bye.